So, good morning everyone. Today, I'm going to talk about how to analyze in vitro immune response of biomaterials with basic concept. So this is our schedule. Now we are in the middle of my class. And then, maybe I'm going to talking about this BAMP, PAMP, and innate immune response here. So yeah, from now on, we are talking about some bacteria infection and then how the body can react against the bacteria infection and then how you culture the bacteria. And finally, how you co-culture bacteria and cell together to mimic infection condition. So last week, maybe 2 weeks ago, yeah, this is our content. So you guys have to remember how to culture cell in different folds. Cell stretching, remember? So your muscle or your skin can be stretched, and compression, your knee, joint, cartilage, and bone, they are compressed. Osmolarity, yeah, some biomass change in the body fluid, they can induce osmolarity change. So in clinically, also, doctors can treat the human using different osmolarity solution in your body fluid. The magnetic field. Naturally, your body has magnetic field. So, to 100% similarly, if we want to mimic your body condition, you have to use magnetic field. So, you can reinforce accelerate magnetic field effect when you use some specific material like magnetic nanoparticle or magnetic something. Yeah. Electrical cue. Your body, especially neuron and muscle network, they are linked and then they are connected by electrical cues. When they transmit their signal from your brain to the muscle, the signal can be transmitted by electrical cue. Yeah, so you have to remember this one. The shear stress, endothelial cell in the blood vessel, they can feel shear stress. So you have to memorize and think about how you utilize this kind of external force to mimic natural body environment. This is an electrical force, yeah. So shear flow, magnetic field, tension and compression, electricity, and even ultrasound cause, if you go to hospital for physical therapy, maybe they can allow you to use some ultrasound inducer to accelerate your muscle regeneration or your pain relief. So also people are looking at this ultrasound. And then how the cell react with this external force. Firstly, the cell have to feel the external force, especially from this ECM and integrin binding. This integrin is another receptor to bind, to recognize the extracellular matrix. After this integrin capturing the ECM, and the ECM that can be moved from cell stretching, compression, osmolarity, etc. Also, this cell directly feel the stress from the body fluid, especially shear stress or electrical cue somehow and electromagnetic field. So you have to remember how the target cell that can be influenced by which kind of external force. And then when you think about the single cell level, how the cell can feel from integrin, ECM binding, or some piezoreceptor, or other kind of receptor from the body fluid. So you have to remember that, think about, and then how this external signal can be transmitted to the nucleus. Sometimes, like integrin, they are directly connected until the nucleus membrane and even the chromatin. So when you just little shift it, directly within few milliseconds, this force can be transmitted to the chromatin. And then your chromatin change and your mRNA expression can be changed. And then protein level also change. So in piezo receptor, especially they can be reacted by electrical cue or some stretching mode. And then when this piezo receptor, they are changed, some calcium influx are accelerated, and this calcium influx that can affect the whole cytosol signaling and the nucleus gene expression. So today we are talking about the basic immune response or biomaterials. So could you raise your hand if you have had a lecture about the immunology before? Raise your hand, immunology. Okay, and then raise your hand if you don't know anything about immunology. You didn't take any lecture. Okay, half and half. So today we are talking about this basic immunology and innate immune, adaptive immune, and macrophage phenotype M1 and M2, and TRL receptor, PAMP, DAMP, in vitro work, how to use biomaterials. Maybe some of them, you guys know everything, or some of you don't know anything. Okay? So simply, let's see. Immunology, what is immunology? Your body recognizes self, non-self. Self means your body. Non-self means not your body. So let's imagine your body can meet bacteria. How they recognize it? If they recognize, oh, this bacteria is myself, and then they do not kill the bacteria. But once your body can recognize, oh, this microbiome is recognized non-self, and then they have to kill. So from your ancestor, maybe from 100,000 years, human body system improved a lot. How? They want to maintain their homeostasis to prolong your lifespan. And then your microbiomes, they want to attack our body because they want to live also in our body. So they always conflict between the external microbiomes and your body system. So immunology is talking about how your body system recognizes the other non-self thing, and then how this non-self thing, when they are attack your body, how they react. And then important thing is that your body also recognizes self, which means if your body recognizes your body, certain cell or certain protein as a non-self, what will happen? Autoimmune disease. Right? So sometimes you encounter many autoimmune diseases in medical drama or other kind of soft drama. So your body, when they are overreacted to your body system, also this is not good. So they have to be balanced. Okay, this is the whole concept of the basic immunology. Now from that immunology, your innate immune is just they recognize the your enemy from the outer surface appearance. Let's say a mammalian cell is quite different from the bacteria and the fungi, right? From their structure and from their outer component. So your body system, called innate immune, they recognize directly the appearance of the microbiomes. And then they kill the cell, basically. So what is the adaptive immune? Adaptive immune, adapted, it takes some time. So innate immune, this is the initial immune. So once they recognize, oh, this bacteria is not myself, I have to kill, try to kill. But there are so many. And then so it's not enough to utilize innate immune to overcome the bacterial infection. And then your body, after uptaking few your enemy, and then you got some phenotype, And then, which means that your innate immune cell, they recognize, oh, I killed this bacteria. So this bacteria have specific certain appearance. So deliver to your neighbors. You have to kill this bacteria. Please help me. And then your neighbor called adaptive immune, they kill the bacteria. This is adaptive immune, right? But actually, when your neighbor killed the bacteria, normally they did not kill themselves. They secrete some antibody. Yeah. Antibody, and they kill the bacteria. So this is called adaptive immune. So maybe you guys have remember, if you are young, you are, I can say, injected certain antigen, right? For, yeah, there are many diseases. When you are young, you have to be injected certain immune antigen for preventing some further infection. Yeah, like, measles or hepatitis B or C virus, something like. So this is all kind of related to adaptive immune. Once you are infected, certain bacterial virus, your body can remember. And then later, this bacterial virus can affect your body system. Your body system already in memory, and then they fastly react. Normally, adaptive immune, it will take 3 or 4 days. But once you are memorized, very, very quickly, 1 or 2 days, they react. So this is the basic concept of innate immune and adaptive immune. And what is the macrophage? Macrophage is related to the innate immune. So as a biomedical scientist, you have to remember the macrophage role. So macrophage, M1 is infection phase, M2 is regenerative phase. So once your macrophage, actually, if you think about your body, and what is the main component? Blood, 70%, right? 70% of the blood, maybe most of the component is the neutrophil and macrophage. Actually, macrophage, their original name is monocyte. But once they are infiltrated to the tissue, which is called macrophage, just we rename. So anyhow, neutrophil maybe 70% and macrophage is 20% of your body fluid, your blood. So neutrophil macrophage, what is their main role? As innate immune. They kill microbiomes. And then once they are killed, they have to regenerate, right? So in contrast to the neutrophil, macrophage, they have a regenerative role. So macrophage always, they have to change their role from M1 inflammatory and M2 regenerative. So your body system, yeah, always have to be balanced. So once, let's say you develop certain biomaterial, but your biomaterial somehow, they maintain the M1 phase of macrophage. What will happen? So actually, from your point of the body, biomaterial, is maybe a lot of chance can be recognized non-self, right? So they somehow they react against the innate immune system. So you have to make some biomaterial which should be recognized as a self material or inert material. Inert means that between the non-self or self. Yeah. So, and then your biomaterial, they can react macrophage initially, absolutely. But when they prolong the M1 phenotype, maybe 1 month, it's not good. Always after a very quick innate immune response from the M1 macrophage, they have to change the M2 macrophage. Okay? So from the in vitro system, maybe you can investigate how your biomaterial react to macrophage. Okay? And then why the TRL, PAMP and DAMP? TRL is kind of receptor, toll-like receptor abbreviation. Your macrophage, neutrophil, or a lot of innate immune cell, they have TRL. So TRL is, another name is a pattern recognizing receptor. Pattern recognized receptor, PRR. So PRR, it is a high category, and the subcategory, TLLR or ILLR, many subcategory. But TLR is the most important thing. So what is the role of the PRR? Is the how your innate immune cell can recognize the microbiomes. Anyhow, they have to capture. They have to how to spread your hand and then capture the microbiomes. This is the PRR and TLR, okay? Is another receptor. And then, so if your hand can recognize your microbiomes and feel, oh, this is very ugly, it is non-self. And then they have to kill or secrete something. So this is some TLR. And then what is the PAMP and DAMP? PAMP and DAMP, pathogen associated molecular pattern. DAMP is damage associated molecular pattern. So just remember, PAMP is pathogen, DAMP is damage. Pathogen means bacteria, virus, okay? So how you recognize the bacteria virus? Touch the face, they don't have any face, but they can feel the bacteria DNA or bacteria or virus RNA. So this is some called PAMP, okay? What is the DAMP? DAMP is mostly they are from the origin of your body. Let's say your body is severely damaged by bone wound, and then your fractured DNA are overflowed, your tissue. And then also your innate immune system, they should recognize the DAMP, damage something, and then react. React means they have to engulf, they have to eat these bad things to clean and then regenerate it, right? So this DAMP is mostly from your body system when they are damaged. So how they recognize your trash some molecule, mostly recognized as a DNA. Your cell, all your cells have DNA, but your cell, your DNA can be damaged, or fractured, or they are split. This your innate immune also can recognize this damaged DNA and the engulf. So this is some DAMP. So briefly, you just memorize PAMP is associated pathogen. Pathogen means bacteria, virus. DAMP is mostly from your body system injured. And then also, this PAMP, DAMP should be recognized by innate immune cell. And in innate immune cell, how they react? From the TLR receptor. This receptor should recognize RNA, DNA, some other things. And then this innate immune, mostly neutrophil and macrophage, okay? Now you finish this. If you understand this whole picture, you can finish this class, okay? And then after completing understanding this whole phenotype, you can also make some idea how to use this concept to develop the Bible to you, okay? So for your understanding, yeah, I'm gonna show up this YouTube, okay?